What if your eye colour holds a secret, passed down through thousands of years of ancestry? From icy blue eyes in Northern Europe to deep hazel tones in Iberia, every shade tells a story. So in this video, we're going to explore the fascinating links between eye colour and ancestry. Now look at this table. It shows the breakdown of eye colours across the globe. As you can see, brown is by far the most common, at around 70 to 80% of the world's population. Depending on the source, either grey or green eyes is considered the rarest eye colour on Earth. And please let me know your eye colour and ancestry in the comments below. Now, varying levels of melanin is the main driver of your eye colour, which is largely driven by genetic mutations in the OCA2 and HERC2 genes. Gender also seems to influence eye colour to some degree. Various studies have shown that men are more likely to have blue eyes than women, which could be linked to higher estrogen levels. Now let's look at all the different eye colours and their ancestral links. First up is brown eyes, the original human eye colour, and at one point all human beings had brown eyes. They are caused by a very high concentration of melanin in the iris, a protective pigment that helps shield the eyes from ultraviolet radiation. From an ancestral perspective, brown eyes have always been advantageous near the equator, most notably in Africa of course. This higher concentration of melanin in brown eyes offers much more protection against intense sunlight than say blue eyes. Now you sometimes see people refer to black eyes, but from a biological perspective, they are typically extremely dark brown. While they may appear black to the naked eye, under strong lighting, they usually reveal brown or reddish tones. Now look at this table. It shows the breakdown of brown eyes per region of the globe. They are highest in sub-Saharan Africa and East Asia of course, at over 99%. North Africa shows a little more variability though, at around 90 to 95%. Colours like hazel and green are slightly more common here, and we even see grey eyes in some Berber populations of North Africa that we will discuss later. What is interesting is that the different regions of Europe show an incredible level of variability of brown eyes as this table shows. People in southern Europe, in places like Spain, Italy, Greece and Portugal, have much higher levels of brown eyes than people in northern Europe, at 70 to 90% compared to 20 to 30% in the north. Various factors influence this. These include climate and also admixture events, as southern Europe had much more contact with North African ancestry than northern Europe down through history. And speaking of Europe, this leads us nicely on to blue eyes. Now blue eyes are obviously a key marker of European ancestry, and they're very old on the continent. This is Cheddar Man for instance, a 10,000 year old hunter-gatherer who lived in ancient England, and we know that he probably had blue eyes or blue-green eyes. We know this because he had the mutations in the HERC2 and OCA2 genes, which are the main cause of lighter eyes through reducing melanin production. And he wasn't an isolated case. Many other European hunter-gatherers had blue eyes or lighter eyes in general. Despite their appearance though, blue eyes actually have no blue pigment in them at all. Instead, they have a relatively low amount of melanin, which allows light to be scattered in the iris, leading to a blue-looking colour. This is a similar process to why the sky looks blue. Today, blue eyes are the second most common eye colour in the world, found in around 8 to 10% of people. They are obviously most common in Europe, especially in Northern Europe and Northeast Europe, highest in places like the Baltic states, Scandinavia and Finland. Climate is probably a key reason for this, given the dark, wintry environment of Northern Europe. We know in general that lighter eyes are more sensitive to light, and blue eyes seem to perform better in low lighting conditions than brown eyes, as a 2024 paper found. From an evolutionary perspective, one obvious benefit of this would be that blue-eyed individuals had a better ability to hunt in low light conditions than darker-eyed individuals. Various other factors also play their role though, and I do discuss these in a previous video on the origin and reason for blue eyes in general. Outside of Europe, we also see blue eyes in some other populations. The Americas is the prime example of this. In North America, around 15 to 30% of people have blue eyes. Further south in Latin America, we see blue eyes in between 1 and 10% of people. These levels are largely a result of European admixture, either through the direct migration of European families or through people's mixing with Europeans. Various events down through history played a role in this spread, but the age of European empires and colonisation was a key episode. The likes of the Spanish, the Portuguese, the British, the Dutch, the French spread European genes across the world, with the genes for blue eyes part of this spread. What about hazel eyes though? Well, they get their name from the hazelnut, and they make up around 5% of the world's population. Hazel eyes are found in a wide range of ethnic groups, but they are most common in people of Brazilian, Middle Eastern and North African or Spanish descent. A 2009 study, for instance, found that 55.2% of their Spanish cohort had hazel green eyes. In the United States, about 18% of people have this eye colour, reflecting the mixed European ancestries there. As I noted in a previous video on Iberian DNA and hazel eyes, they are often found in populations where blue and brown-eyed ancestry has mixed, such as in Iberia. Now, hazel eyes can often appear more green or more brown, and the concentration of melanin is somewhere in between blue eyes and brown eyes, somewhere in the middle, with brown having a lot of melanin and blue having little. A yellow pigment called lipochrome is also usually present as well. This blend allows hazel irises to reflect a mosaic of colours. The science behind hazel eyes is essentially a combination of really scattering on one hand, which is the same phenomenon behind blue eyes, and a moderate amount of melanin in the iris. Next up is amber eyes, which are of a solid golden yellow hue, often compared to the rich colour of honey. This eye colour is distinct from hazel, and the amber eyes usually do not show the mixed greens or browns that hazel eyes do. Instead, they're more of a uniform gold, copper or russet tone. The golden tint comes from the presence of lots of lepichrome, this yellow pigment in the iris, coupled with low to moderate melanin. In the animal kingdom, many creatures have amber eyes. For instance, wolves, domestic cats, owls and eagles often exhibit yellow or orange irises due to similar pigments. They are sometimes known as wolf eyes due to this. In humans, however, pure amber eyes are quite rare, occurring in an estimated 5% of people worldwide. The highest numbers of people with amber eyes are found in Europe, especially southern Europe and places like Spain. We also see them at elevated levels in the Middle East and the Caucasus, as well as North Africa, Latin America and North America to some level. Because amber eyes can sometimes be mistaken for hazel or light brown, their exact distribution is not well documented. Now, one of the most enigmatic and rarest eye colours is green, found in only 2%, around 2% of the world's population. They are most common in people of Celtic or Germanic ancestry, and they're also connected to the Vikings down through history to some degree. If you look at this table, you can see the countries that have the most people with green eyes, which are Ireland, Scotland and Iceland. They are also relatively common in places like Scandinavia and Germany. One study noted that among Americans of European descent, those with Celtic or Germanic heritage had the highest prevalence of green eyes, at around 16%. In Iceland, a survey found green eyes in about 18 to 20% of women and 8 to 10% of men. This hints at a curious sex difference when it comes to this eye colour. Now, true green eyes result from a combination of pigments on one hand and scattering. They have a moderate amount of melanin, plus this golden yellow pigment called lepichrome in the iris. When light enters, the brown melanin can give a yellow or light brown cast, which mixes with blue light scattering from the stroma, producing green. From a historical perspective, it is plausible that green eyes emerged in populations where blue eye variants and brown eye variants intermingled, although they do have a complex genetic makeup that isn't really fully understood yet. Some ancient DNA evidence hints that green eyes may have been present in Eurasia during the Bronze Age. A 2009 study, for instance, concluded that South Siberians were blue or green-eyed, fair-skinned and light-haired people, and that they might have played a role in the early development of the Tarim Basin civilization. Now, next up is another very rare eye colour, potentially the rarest eye colour in the world, grey. Now, estimates do seem to vary on how rare they are. Some estimate that around 1% of the world's population have grey eyes, whereas others put the figure at more like 3%. Like blue eyes, grey eyes have a low level of melanin and rely on light scattering, but scientists think there's maybe an extra factor at play that distinguishes them from blue. One hypothesis is that grey eyes have more collagen deposits in the stroma, which is the front layer of the iris, which tend to scatter light differently. Others argue that grey and blue eyes might have different concentrations of melanin. What we do know is that under magnification, grey irises often show specks of yellow and brown pigment amidst the grey. Now, grey eyes are most commonly found in the same general regions as blue eyes, i.e. Northern and Eastern Europe. For example, grey eyes can be frequently seen among the people in the Baltic states, Scandinavia, as well as in parts of Russia. Some Vikings also seem to have had grey eyes and probably helped to spread this trait to some degree. Grey eyes also pop up in unexpected places though, likely due to ancient migrations. Certain Berber peoples in North Africa, for example, such as the Shawia people of Algeria, have a higher occurrence of grey or grey-blue eyes, a legacy perhaps of Euro-Mediterranean gene flow over centuries. Grey or blue eyes can also be seen occasionally in the Middle East, Iran and South Asia. For instance, amongst the peoples of Afghanistan or northern India, reflecting admixture with Eurasian steppe ancestors or simply the diversity within those large populations. These instances remind us how human migrations and conquests have spread eye genes far and wide. But what is your eye colour? Please let me know in the comments below and let me know what your ancestry is as well. And as we have seen, your eye colour can actually reveal quite a lot about your ancestry. But to find out more about Hazel Eyes and Iberian DNA, please click here. Thanks for watching, please subscribe and hit the bell, and let me know your thoughts in the comments below, and I'll see you next time.